So as Jim alluded, there are several characteristics to distinguish mRNAs that are delivered externally from those that are internal. So mRNAs are found in the cytoplasm or the nucleus. They're generally not supposed to be found in the endosome. And so the cell recognizes mRNAs in that compartment as being potentially viruses. There's also several characteristics that are added to the RNA during the processing events, such as addition of a cap and methylated caps that also distinguish it and license it as a self-RNA. And also, self-RNAs tend to lack long double-stranded structures that are found in viruses. And there are certain viral structure elements which are detected by the innate immune system. All right, so the endosomal innate immune receptors, what we call them pattern recognition receptors, are primarily toll-like receptors, 3, 7, and 8, which recognize single-stranded and double-stranded RNA. And these are basically virus sensors. Now, depending on your platform that you use for delivery, you may transit through different compartments, and this is important. So when you're looking at people's data about, you know, certain biology, keep in mind if you're using a different delivery vehicle. So for example, you're using an endosome, you may be a liposome, you may be trafficking through an endosomal compartment, whereas you're doing an ex vivo electroporation of some CD34 positive cells, you may bypass that compartment. And so the delivery vehicle that you use is going to depend, is going to impact what characteristics your messenger RNA might have. All right, so there are also a number of cytosolic receptors that recognize mRNAs in the cytosol. And these would include PKR, which recognizes short double-stranded RNAs, MDA5, which recognizes long double-stranded RNAs, RIG-I recognizes 5' triphosphates. There's a family of proteins called IFITs, which recognize 5' triphosphates and CAP0. And then lastly, there's a newly discovered pathway called cGAS sting, which recognizes cytosolic DNA ends. All right, so now I'm going to shift gear and talk about the manufacturing design considerations for a messenger RNA.